Point of order, Mr. Ivan Lewis.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. In a debate which took place, I'm seeking your guidance last week on High Speed 2. The Minister, the Honourable Member for Wealden, was asked very directly whether any non-disclosure clauses had been included in redundancy agreements with former staff at HS2. She said on several occasions that no such non-disclosure arrangements were included in those redundancy arrangements. A subsequent parliamentary answer to that debate, Mr. Speaker, confirms that in fact there were a number of such non-disclosure clauses in agreements with staff that were made redundant. Is there anything at this stage Mr. Speaker can do in terms of the Minister being accountable for answers she gave during the course of that debate?
Well, that is that every honourable member, or right honourable member, is responsible for the veracity of what he or she says in this House. In the event that a member discovers he or she has inadvertently misled the House, it is incumbent upon that member to correct the record. That obligation applies across the House, and of course it applies to ministers as well as to those who are not part of the executive branch.
I also want to raise briefly the question of HS2. What I've discovered in recent weeks about HS2 is shocking, Mr. Deputy Speaker. It seems that there are a significant number of former senior staff who, as part of redundancy notices, were made to sign non-disclosure clauses because they had brought to the attention of the senior management of the company that they were not providing accurate information to this House about the true costs of HS2. People were marched off premises, people were made redundant purely because they were whistleblowing and saying that this House and the public were being misled about the costs. I urge the Government and the Department for Transport to come totally clean and be transparent about this issue, because if they don't come clean, we're going to drag this information out of them in terms of what I believe is a public scandal. Mr. Deputy.